I believe we don't give enough credit to the molecules that we rely on to function throughout our daily lives. Hello, I'm Tristan Francis, and today I'll be investigating plastic. Polyethylene is one of the most functional plastics and can be used in almost anything, from plastic bags to bulletproof vests. Personally, I use polyethylene every day when I wrap my lunches in glad wrap, or when I use my water bottle, and even when I read using my glasses. Ethylene consists of two carbon atoms and four hydrogen atoms. The carbon atoms are bonded together by a double bond, with two hydrogen atoms bonded to it. This makes ethylene an alkene. Carbon atoms have four valence electrons, which allows this bonding to occur. The functional group of the double bond represents a trigonal planar angle of 120 degrees. Polyethylene consists of long hydrocarbon chains. The double carbon bond is broken to form a single bond, and this leaves a lone valence electron. This valence electron joins onto other carbon atoms to form polyethylene. This is an exothermic reaction, and then in commercial practice is controlled by manipulating the temperature and pressure at which this reaction occurs. This polymerization is the process of creating polyethylene chains from monomer molecules of ethylene. As the carbon atoms are more electronegative at 2.55 than the hydrogen at 2.20, this makes an electronegative difference of 0.35. This demonstrates that the electrons between the molecules are shared equally, creating a nonpolar bond. Nonpolar molecules are affected by a weak transient intermolecular force, which is more commonly known as van der Waals force. The electronegativity that causes the atoms to stick together is termed instantaneous dipole-induced dipole interaction. The partially revealed positive charge of one nucleus will become attracted to the thickened cloud of the negative charge of the neighboring nucleus, causing fluctuation in the polarity structure. There are two major types of polyethylene, low-density polyethylene and high-density polyethylene. Low-density polyethylene relies on the closeness the molecules can come together by the branches, which creates a weaker intermolecular force of the instantaneous dipole-induced dipole interaction. The closeness of the branches decreases the strength, but also makes it more resilient and flexible, which is why you can bend, twist, and stretch glad wrap. High-density polyethylene is the opposite to low-density. Therefore, the induced dipole forces increase as branching decreases. There is very little branching and is therefore more linear, making it stronger in function. The molecular weight also increases as branching decreases, and can increase up to 3 million to 6 million. The increased intermolecular forces makes the fibers so strong the mechanical material has replaced Kevlar in bulletproof vests. This is known as ultra-high molecular weight polyethylene. The crystallinity of polyethylene determines whether or not it's going to be low-density or high-density. The central lamellae and the protruding amorphous chains of the polymers characterize the formation of crystallinity. Low-density polyethylene has low crystallinity, and it has a regular shape with many protruding amorphous chains. This creates the structure of lenses in glasses and allows them to be transparent. Conversely, the regular structure of high-density polyethylene can pack into crystals more easily, forming the central lamellae, and therefore is much stronger. This in turn can stretch the polymers out fully, which is the formation of ultra-high molecular weight polyethylene. Low-density polyethylene is dependent on its unbalanced and asymmetrical amorphous structures, irregular branches and weaker intermolecular forces, whereas high-density polyethylene is dependent on its more regular shape crystallinity, linear branching and stronger intermolecular force. Polyethylene is a very versatile plastic and its physical properties control and determine if it will be used for flexible plastic or protective plastic.